everyone, how is it going? I hope you're doing fine. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create flat illustration landscape using monochromatic color concept with Inkscape. Let's begin. Alright, first let's add some background. Make sure to activate the snap page to the border. Click this icon and go to your rectangle tool. Just drag all the way down, you see this tooltip to here to make it snap. And change the color to this. I'm pressing D to activate the dropper tool. Click, or you can input this color code to this edit objects and place the color code to here. Draw some circle, go to your circle tool, then press Ctrl Shift to scale it proportionally like this. And I change the color to this. I'm pressing D. Then add two more with inner in it, press Ctrl D to duplicate, then hold Ctrl Shift again to scale it proportionally around this, and change the color to this. Okay, one more, duplicate, press Ctrl D, then hold Ctrl Shift to scale it proportionally, change the color to this. Make it group, we're going to place it on the center of the background. Select all this circle and press Ctrl G to group. And make sure you select the circle first and the background later. And go to this align and distribute objects. Just click. Choose the relative to last selected because our last selected is the background. So just click this icon to center it and this. Alright, I'm gonna scale it down a little. Hold Ctrl Shift around this. Now we're going to add the tree silhouette to here. Go to File, Import, and adjust this. Is it okay? We're going to trace it to make it editable. So right now it's in PNG. You cannot edit the color. You want to make it a vector object. Go to Path, Trace Bitmap. Click this update to preview it and hit OK. So now you have the two files, the PNG and this the editable. Just press F2 to see it's editable or not. You see the right one is editable. You can change the color to this color and just delete the old one. We're going to place it on the circle. Alright, scale it down, press Ctrl Shift to scale it proportionally. This and duplicate a few times, press Ctrl D. Make some nice placement. Right, I'm gonna duplicate it again. After that, select all the trees, then press Ctrl G to make it group. Then we want to make a clipping mesh with this outer circle. So just click this outer circle, press Ctrl D, sorry, make it ungroup first, right click, just ungroup, so you know it's selected one by one, and press Ctrl D to duplicate, then select the trees, click this, and right click, just set clip. So now it's clipped to the circle. You see this little white gap here, so let's move it by scaling the trees a little bit, click the trees, and hold Ctrl Shift, just a little bit movement. Then let's make this color same with the trees. With Bezier tool, press B, then select all this. I'm pressing D, change color to this, and remove the stroke. Make it group with the trees, click this and the trees, press Ctrl G. The reason why I'm choosing group because you still can move the single object while union cannot do that. Let's see if I'm pressing F2. You see it's highlight the single object, then click, then move it. Now you see you still can move the trees. Add more trees to place it behind these trees. Go to File, Import, and I choose this. Just hit open and OK. make it as the vector object, go to path, trace bitmap, and just hit OK. Let's close it. Now you see these two files, the editable one and the PNG one. Just delete this PNG and change the color to this color. Scale it down. Place it behind the tree. Okay, I'm gonna duplicate it by pressing Ctrl D. You can flip horizontally by pressing H on your keyboard to make more variation of the trees. Same method with the previous, select all the trees, make it group, then make it clip. Duplicate the outer circle, press Ctrl D. Then click the trees, right click, choose set clip. Add the last trees, go to file, import, and choose this. It's okay. And convert it to vector object to make it editable and scale it down. Just gonna delete this. Change the color to this color. And place it behind this tree. I'm gonna flip it by pressing H to flip it horizontally. Place it on the behind. Make this group, press Ctrl G, then make it clip, duplicate the circle, and click this, right click, choose set clip. Next thing, draw some mounted shape with the bezier tool, press B on your keyboard, then let's draw, change the color to this, remove the stroke, make it clip with the circle, press Ctrl D, and select this tool, right click, choose set clip, move it on the back. And draw one more, press B on the keyboard. Move the stroke and make it clip. Place it on the back. Create the moon object to here with the circle tool, click this. And hold Ctrl Shift to make it proportional scale. And move it to the back. On this. Place it. And place it in the middle of the circle. So I'm selecting this, and to the last selected. Okay, just bring it up a little. Then make some glow effect by duplicating this. Press Ctrl D, and go to this edit objects. You can increase the blur to make it like glow effect. Place it on the back. Very nice. Next, add some beard shape to here with the bezier tool. Press B on your keyboard. Just draw some simple V shape. Then click on here. Then in here, just drag it and hold Shift to lock the corner and release. Alright, just drag it again. Hold Shift to lock the corner. Then connect to this dot. Okay, change the color to this color and remove the stroke. You can move the nodes to modify it. Okay, then change the opacity to 70. Duplicate another one, press Ctrl D, then make it flip, press H, scale it down, change the opacity to 50. The last shape is the cloud, so we're gonna draw some cloud with the circle like this, change the color to white, make it 100, and duplicate, press Ctrl D, place it on here, then here. And press B on your keyboard to draw some shape like this. and hold shift to lock the corner. Then on here, just connect the dots. Remove the stroke and make it union by selecting all. Go to path and choose union. Right, place it on here. Scale it down, press Ctrl Shift. Change the color to this. I'm pressing D to activate the dribble tool. Click this and duplicate the other one. Press Ctrl D and change the color to this and scale it down. Do the same for this place. Press Ctrl D to duplicate, then place it on here. You can flip it by pressing H. Get another one, change it to this color. Let me add some text to here. This is optional, guys. You can skip this process if you're happy with the result. So I'm just gonna type, change the font to, scale it up. Change the color to white and make some line effect to here with the Bezier tool. Just duplicate this. Press H. That's it, everyone. Hope you learned something new, how to make this flat illustration landscape using Inkscape. I'm Zeki from Zeki Design. Create something good today. Thanks for watching.